Until that night, when something evil came looking for a soul to possess.
I can't stop thinking about your husband.
That creep, forget him.
Was this Abby?
I'm gonna take old Long George upstairs and fuck the shit out of him.
Now the fun starts.
In the name of the one infinite God.
Was this Abby?
Hear me, demon. Leave this woman's body.
something evil. From something evil. Abby. Rated R.
We'll be right back. death metal podcast watchers for moving towards Halloween. So yeah, that was Evisium with Sharon from Dercada on bass. That's right. That was Evisium. It's members of Rochevor and Dercada, but it's a band formed by Mark Mastro of Rochevor. What's up, Andres Rest? I think coming from Germany, right? I saw Rochevor performance on Roy's show last night, and it wasn't the same guy. That's correct, because this is Evisium. This is Mark Mastro. This is his main project, so yeah, they're pretty sick. That was a show from the beginning of the month, so not even that long ago. They have reformed. They have a couple old demos, and then like one old demo, and then like a demo-type CD. And then also they have a whole new other recording in the partially in the can, let's say. So we're going to check out some more horrific and death metal stuffs.
From the door of hell to the dark of space, come prepared for a double assault of demonic terror. In Beyond the Door 2 and the Dark, two horror classics of death and damnation. Beyond the Door 2 and the Dark, rated R.
We'll be right back. defeated them. This is to fulfill our wrath. One vacant soul still left to join us. Join us. He shall fall like all others before him.
All right. So, yeah, we're back. I fumbled the ball right there. Remembering how crazy this sounded when I first heard it, not so much anymore. True Pioneer. Yeah, Necrophagia was definitely ahead of their time. I also thought it was crazy when I sounded it. When I first heard it. Long time ago. I remember many car trips with Incantation listening to Seasons of the Dead on repeat. What's good, Jesus Drinks Jet Fuel and J.R.R. Tolkien, Bloodstoned, my man Andrew from Abominator I saw was in here, Necron, and Andres Rest. What's going on, brother? That was Evisium. So, yeah, as far as the, in the chat, what's up, brother? Fucked up. Uber's gonna hate me. I'm gonna puke. Yeah, late night evil. That's what this is about. Isn't this Halloween, right? We gotta get evil. Late night shit. You know, like the dark is upon us. I mean, I like to, like I said in episode other day, I like to get psyched for Halloween. And this is my way, I'd say nowadays, where I get a little more psyched about it. I go back to weird stuff like, you know, like say this would like, I'm just going to play like the beginning little part of this, but like this stuff like kind of like, you know, was like the panic, you know?
On the ABC News Magazine 2020 with Hugh Downs and Barbara Walters. Are your kids renting a movie this weekend? Horror films like these are the most popular choice. Graphic orgies of blood and violence.
And they watch 15 murders in an hour and a half.
Children mesmerized.
I like the gore.
But are they harmless?
It's always a female victim, and is generally in a sexual context.
With reports that life may now be imitating art, Bob Brown shows you what the kids are watching. VCR Horrors. Also...
We'll be right back. Das Messer, gib mir das Messer, gib mir das Messer, verdammte Scheiße nochmal. Jetzt kommt die Belohnung.
Das ist Endstation. Ich schneid den kaputt. Du Dreckstück. Gib mir deine Tände.
Komm wieder zu dir, so schnell stirbt man nicht. Was haben Sie vor? Sie auf den Ofen drücken, damit sie nicht verblutet.
Oh Gott!
Wenn ihre Wunden auf den Platten zubringen.
Right, so that's a rare German gore movie. It was called Ostermontag from 91. So there's a lot more to it, but seek it out on your own, man. Definitely, it's a sick flick. Comments are crazy. I believe so, yeah. I think this is an Andreas Schorsch joint. He's one of his earlier jammies. So up next, this is going to be a little shadier because the video quality's like shadier and probably play lower. But the bottom line is this, I was at this gig, for the first time in America, they claimed that Goblin was going to play live. It was at a horror convention and, it was like the best horror convention I've been to, I have to say, because, Ruggero Diodato was there as a guest speaker. And then they said that Goblin was going to play. And then they had Jim Van Beber was there. I remember seeing Killjoy there. The guy who made the wax mask, Sergio Stilvate, who took over for the wax mask for Lucio Fulci, he was there. And he did a lot of special effects for like really good like Fulci movies and stuff. Sergio Stilvate. And he did like the killer crocodile and he did a bunch of brutal shit. I'm trying to think who else was there. There was like these sit down things where you could like ask questions about Cannibal Holocaust and stuff. It was super, super sick, dude. And then, so there was a live show during it. And so this band plays and it wasn't Goblin, but it was Zibonia, which was Claudio Simonetti's band. So we're going to play some live stuff. From this, and Sergio Stilvate took over for a movie for Lucio Fulci called The Wax Mask. So if you check that out, it's pretty brutal. I mean, I don't know if Fulci filmed parts of it or was just involved with it. And then we're also going to be a collaboro with Dario Argento, and those guys had beef. Dario Argento and Fulci had beef for a long time. So they decided to make a collabro movie called The Wax Mask, and then he died during that. And then another director took over. His name was Sergio Stilvate, but he was like the special effects guy. But if you look on some of the sleazy Italian movies, he's the special effects guy on a lot of those. So you could look, and he did like a stand-up. He did a stand-up gig. He did a stand-up, man, and it was sick, dude. It was like, he reminded me of like an Italian like crime dude. So like that was cool too. So we're gonna play. I wanted to play something from that. There was a live show recorded of it. So I'm gonna play a portion of it.
That's not even your house.
My video camera directed by Sergio Stivaletti. Okay, I would like to introduce you tonight my new band called Demonia. Did you see the video clip taken from our album? Thank you. Our new album is our first album is called Dario Argento Tribute. It's a CD complete and dedicated to Dario Argento and his soundtracks, Goblin soundtracks, Ennio Morricone soundtracks, my soundtracks, and Keith Emerson soundtracks. Tonight we present all the CD. I would like to introduce my band, the band Demonia, Tita Tani on the drums. Mr. Federico Amorosi on the bass. And the new guitar player, we changed guitar, he's the best, Davide Aru. So we start with the first song taken from one of my best favorite songs, taken from Dawn of the Dead, L'Alba dei Morti Viventi, Dawn of the Dead.
Final tap!
So that was Demonia. And the funny thing is, you say the cameraman was drunk. So, like, the cameraman was Sergio Stavante, who was like, because the guy says right in the beginning, Claudio Simonetti, he says, he goes, Sergio Stavante is my VHS camera guy. So I don't know if that was the guy that filmed the video, though. So, but I thought that was cool. So it might have been Sergio Stavante himself. So that might answer your question, you know? So yeah, this was a, this was a Dawn of the Dead. Like, they were playing, which is not a Claudio Simonetti song, if I'm not mistaken. It's a Goblin song. I shot some tight footage of from the Demons tour. I'm sure it'll turn up sooner or later. Sick. Yeah, that Demons tour seemed brutal, too. This particular live thing was from like 2001. So it was like 20 years ago or whatever. It was a long time ago. Going to a horror convention where there was like a band playing was like probably like this was like the rarest one, because this was the only time. Like once or twice I went to Chiller Theater and they had some like rockabilly, like rock ass bands, you know, dressed up as like the misfit looking guys doing like, you know, horror related music. But this show in particular, when you had Claudio Simonetti there, who was like one of the godfathers of like horror soundtrack shit, and then like he said, they did a CD which was a tribute to Dario Argento. So they did songs by Goblin on there, Ennio Morricone, and Keith Emerson, as well as Claudio Simonetti songs. And then there's a CD of that. It's sick. And a live one, too. And then that was some live tracks from that. So I thought, you know, if anyone gets down with Dawn of the Dead, I mean, how hard can you get when someone's doing covers of that? And there was a cover of one of the Ennio Morricone songs, so I thought that was bugged out, because, like, usually there's no cover tune bands of, like, horror soundtracks. There's one or two others, I mean. There's one or two others. There's this, which is, like, if you know some deep cuts of really bizarre horror movies, you might know what this is. So we'll play it here. So appreciate you guys for tuning in to my impromptu three-night horror soundtrack and death metal extravaganza. Let me see here. I think I moved the song to play it, and now, but here's a different song from now.
Thank you.
right, so this is the song I'm going to play, though, and tell me if you guys could recognize this. I could play the trailer, too, afterwards, but, hold on, I got to go back to the other folder now. Yeah. So, if you recognize this, maybe you get a prize. Someone nailed it as close as you could get. Something Italian. Definitely. So you, that's pretty close though. But yeah, no one hit it. But it's a pretty rare track. Maybe it'll show up in one of the trailers that I show. We're going to go back into playing some death metal and horror soundtrack. We're past the soundtrack zone at this stage. But there's other good music out there besides just listening to fucking death metal records, right? That's why I went on here to play some, like, just different obscure stuff. Because, like, if this is what I listen to, this is the whole purpose of this show, I guess you could call it. So it's like, this is what I listen to, and if you, you know, like, here, check out some stuffs. Stuffs. yeah, so we have my man Philippe is in the house from Belgium. And then I was saying at Hell Belgium, Cryptoptyzine in 93. 93 indeed. So, hell yeah, man. That's some real shit. Fanzines were the fucking guiding light of death metal, man. And all the music that was played back then. Because, like, between the comp tapes, the video trading, tape trading, and all, everything that was going on in the underground, like the way around metal was like through writing to people. And like sometimes you can only get stuff like this if you wrote to people. We'll be right back. right. Ceremonium. Yeah, I lived with Ceremonium. And I will hang out with Ceremonium. And then Oscar, I know him for years, actually. Met him outside a Putrefact show near G. Willikers. So, yeah, sick shit. We go back. In death metal, a lot of people are, you know, the true old school obviously goes back with each other. Which you go back with your friends. So, I mean, that's how it goes. This was a bugged out one. Creep shows. Many creep shows out there. So maybe if even one person saw that and they're like, you know what? I want to see that movie now. It's called House from 77. Yes, it was a Japanese film. And yeah, the Japanese do it a certain way, right? So, I mean, they always did for horror. It's not a ploy, right? They always did it a certain way. There's a lot of good Japanese horror movies. And then even some of them continued into the 2000s, you know? A lot of stuff was influenced by them. When you see a little, you know, girl coming out of like a freaking manhole, you know? So up next, we're on to the death metal side of death metal podcast, not the horror side. Metal podcast all day. If you guys want to check it out too, so Ceremonium, yeah, are they back in action? They're back in action. There's a new release on Necroharmonic. Since I always don't even flex on any of my Necroharmonic releases on here and just focus on other bands and death metal, we do have a release out with them, which is that old tape right there that we played. And then, what do you call it? Some shirts done by a German artist who was pretty cool. So definitely, yeah, Nightfall in Heaven, You Lost It. We're going to reissue it as something. So it'll be out on a record or a tape or both. So that's coming, you know? It's just, I wanted to release, for Ceremonium, we wanted to release the stuff that was unreleased. So that was the unreleased rehearsal demo. So back when you visited us, Philippe, there was in 1993, we were hanging out and listening to this demo and then putting out Ceremonium 7 inches and shit. But I listened to this demo rehearsal from 92 and then it made me put out the 7 inch. So then we finally put out the rehearsal demo as like a tape and stuff just to put it out there. Because in the scene now, it's like there's people trading tapes. So, yeah, it's out. And it will be a reissue of the Nightfall in Heaven. You know what? I don't have a photo of it, but Oscar from Ceremonium just popped up the Nightfall in Heaven DAT tape. And he showed me a photo, and we've been looking for it for a little while. So onwards towards the gore. Necroharmonic would like to sponsor any horror soundtrack labels if you want to send your stuff.
Devil does. He grants us virtues to expand his kingdom, the only valid one.
God, with his lack of knowledge, does not understand this truth and opposes it with false thoughts and prayers.
God, silence!
Satan, 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 our Lord and Master, I acknowledge thee as my God and Prince. I promise to serve and obey thee as long as I shall live. I renounce the other God and all the saints.
Don't listen to them. Don't listen to them.
Our Lord and Master, I acknowledge.
Go out of the room. Sister Mary, take the children out of the room. Go. Go.
As long as I shall live. Satan. I promise thee that I will do as much evil as I can. I will draw everyone else to evil. I won't fail to serve and adore thee. I give thee my life and my soul.
Thank you.
So, rest in peace, yeah, Jim Fleet from Phlegm. A good friend of mine. I'll talk about him afterwards. I think he needs his own show, basically. So, Death Metal Podcast will probably do, like, a Phlegm show. The Phlegm show about Jim Fleet. Because we were friendly, so I feel like I could talk on it. So, rest in peace to Jim Fleet. Let's listen to another one for Fleet.
We'll be right back.
Whoops, I cut it off right at the break. Could Flea tell the future, dude? Did you see the titles? So like I said, in the future, we'll do an episode just about Phlegm. Like, Necroharmonic released a double CD of Phlegm. So I really had to take an extensive dive into their demos and everything. And I know them as people, so, like, we did this as a double CD from a recording that I had from, like, 93 of a live soundboard or whatever. So, I think if anyone could take a deep dive into Phlegm, it would probably be me, right? So I think, eventually we'll do a thing. And also, shout out to Cam. He had done that interview with Fleet. Fleet and me talked about an interview, and then he had trouble getting on StreamYard. So we didn't get to do it, which sucks. I love Fleet. I feel bad that he died, you know, because he was my boy. All right, on to a tricky treat.
Okay, sweetheart. The kids should be ready when you're back.
This one is better than last year.
So glad we do this tradition.
Yeah, son. All right, let's give a moment of thanks. Okay. Okay, here we go.
Ew, it's still warm.
Ooh. See?
Come on.
Atta girl.
Yep. Oh,
nice.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Oh, those are some nice brains. All right, sweetie. Get in there, we're gonna pop this thing.
And, now that's an eye opener.
Oh. Oh, nice!
Yeah.
Maybe a bit of a pull at the end. There you go. Oh. There it is.
You found a good one this year, honey.
Yes, I did.
Wow.
You kids ready to go outside?
Yeah.
Okay, time for the family picture. Hold very still, kids. Trick or treat!
We'll be right back.
So yeah, Dripping Decay, they're super sick. They got a newer one too. They just played the old video because it's gory. It's Halloween, bruh. Play the sleaze. So, damn, man, where the hell my thing? It says it's finished. Let me try this again here. Too many things. So what are you guys up to for actual... This is Halloween weekend, right? Don't people normally do stuff like on Fridays and Saturdays? No one dressed up and like went out and like went crazy at a party or something? People stayed home and ate on the internet? Thank you.
Hai avuto paura.
Devi essere proprio nei guai, amico. Perché forse io ho qualcosa che interessa a tua moglie. Che cos'è mai che spinge l'uomo ad uccidere?
Something creeping in the dark. Evil shit. That was a pretty bizarre movie. Up next, death metal.
Thank you. here. A fragment of tissue found under the fingernails of one of your companions. Barbarously murdered in the middle of the night, 1 week ago. Our scientific analysis has traced them to this foulard, which was used to strangle Carol Peterson. If you have ever seen a scarf like this on any person you can identify, it is your duty to report it either to the police or the university authorities. I might add that no one in Perugia, either man or woman, is safe until this killer is captured and brought to justice.
Yeah.
It had been a long time between men for the three strange sisters.
I think I can offer you something interesting.
What did they want with a man in the house of psychotic women? These are the girls in a house of psychotic women. Yvette lives in a wheelchair. And Nicole. And Claude.
Do you think a person would be satisfied with this?
My two sisters are very unlucky. No man will look at them. One's a paralytic, and the other, with that hand, it's repugnant.
Well, for me, I like them both.
Of psychotic women? What do they do to a man in the house of psychotic women? What else?
Stop it!
House of Psychotic Women from Independent International. Rated R. Under 17, not admitted without parent.
Thank you.
All right, that was Embryo from Norway. They're from Sweden, I'm sorry. They're from it was like pre-Maze of Torment stuff from 91. So they did a split and pretty obscure stuff, good solid death metal, you know. In the old days of the old Demigods and Adremelich and everything. Embryonic, Embalmed, Sweden. So, you know, there was good stuff. Buttocks, Cadaver. There was definitely a lot of good bands. Balvas, right? Definitely worth checking out. The Norwegian and Swedish scene of the old days. House of Usher. So, all right. So, this is going to conclude the death metal podcast, Horror Shiz. I appreciate you guys for tuning in post on Carl's show. I didn't even really plan to go live, actually, so we just do it. I want to go out with action, so let's see here. Let's see what could play. You don't get banned. Let's see, man. All right, good night.
We really screwed ourselves this time. Trying to stay there for the last shot. I don't even know where we are now. But I know they followed us and we lost everything trying to escape. We're screwed, we're trapped.
Watch it, Alan, I'm shooting.
Oh, good Lord. It's unbelievable. It's horrible. I can't understand the reason for such cruelty.
She knew that in the shadow there was a shadow ready to strike.
He's planning to murder you.
Why?
He's been offered $20,000 to kill you.
By who? He knew that this blood, this strange trinket, hid a spine-chilling mystery of which he was a part. She knew that those footsteps belonged to a man who had been alive and was now perhaps dead. A man who disappeared from the living. I disappeared at the right moment to reappear at the right moment. She had seen him killed. And yet now, he was close beside her, haunting her to the point of madness.
Jean!
Her voice, so sweet. Her hand, so perverse. Her body, so sweet, so perverse. Nicole, naked, unknown. Surrounded by vice, violence. Terror, ecstasy, death. Caught in the gears of a monstrous machine that was dragging her down into a bottomless pit.
His hands. I'm always ashamed and angry for feeling that excitement.
Nicole. So sweet, so perverse. Jean, was he alive? Or was he dead? All that he touched was so sweet, so perverse. Driven to frenzy, her hands to the blackest crime. She existed in a nightmare of horror and rapture. Even the air she breathed was so sweet, so perverse.
Love is strong as our love. No need to ask reasons why.